Hi my dear friends, in this video we will talk about a very easy trick with the help of which you can easily remember all the branches of the celiac trunk. So now here first very important question is that what is celiac trunk? So what is the question? Question is what is celiac trunk? So now this is the thoracic aorta coming. This is what? Thoracic aorta. And this is the diaphragm. This is what? Diaphragm. And at the level of T12 thoracic vertebra, the diaphragm has an opening, and that opening is called as aortic. That opening is called as the aortic hiatus. And this aortic hiatus, that is that opening present in the diaphragm at the level of T12 thoracic vertebra, is for the entry of this thoracic aorta to reach into the abdomen. So as soon as the thoracic aorta enters through the aortic hiatus, then the thoracic aorta becomes now the abdominal. This is abdominal aorta now. So from T12 up to the L4 lumbar vertebra, this is at the level of L4 lumbar vertebra, the abdominal aorta terminates by giving two terminal branches, one on left side and one on right side. So this one is the left common iliac artery and this one is the right common iliac artery. So this is at the level of T12, this is the L1, this is the L2, and this one is the L3 level. So now in between T12 and L1 level, in between T12 and L1 level, at somewhere here the celiac trunk arises. So this is what celiac trunk, and this celiac trunk is the anterior branch of the abdominal aorta, and this anterior branch is what is single, that is why it is unpaired. So celiac trunk is the unpaired anterior branch of the abdominal aorta. So now here MCQ's point of view, what are the MCQs can be asked from this topic up till now? So first very important question is that at which level the thoracic aorta becomes abdominal aorta. So this is at the T12 thoracic vertebra, and at which level the celiac trunk arises from the abdominal aorta. So this is in between, most authors says that in between T12 and L1 vertebra, and some author says that let's suppose this is what L1 vertebra. So the celiac trunk arises at the upper border of the L1 lumbar vertebra. So this is the celiac trunk. So my dear friends, please keep in mind that very important point here, that some author says that celiac trunk arises in between the level of T12 and L1 vertebrae, and some author says that celiac trunk arises at the level of the upper border of the L1 lumbar vertebra. Now friends, let's see the branches of the celiac trunk. Now for the branches, just imagine for a while that this is a person, and this is head of the person, and this head is supposed to be celiac trunk. Now these are the ears of the person. This is chest. This is what? This is chest. And these are the hands. This is the chest. And this is the abdomen, and these are the legs. Okay, so this is our celiac trunk and its branches. So head is the celiac trunk, chest is one branch, and these two ears are other branches, and these hands and abdomen is the branch of this chest, and these legs are branch of this abdomen. So now here in this picture I am showing ears like this. So these are the ears, this is chest, these are hands, this is abdomen, and these are legs, and this head is the celiac trunk. So this is first branch, this is second branch, and this is the third branch from the celiac trunk. So first branch is the left gastric artery, second branch is the splenic artery, third branch is the common hepatic artery, and common hepatic artery again gives three branches. One is the right gastric artery, second one is the proper hepatic artery, third branch is the gastroduodenal artery. Now proper hepatic artery gives two branches, right hepatic artery and left hepatic artery, and from the right hepatic artery there is a branch for the gallbladder called as the cystic artery. So now for the celiac trunk, whenever you hear the term celiac trunk, then just imagine a person having two ears, chest, hands, abdomen, and these two legs. So this is our celiac trunk and its branches. Now friends, let's suppose this is a person, this is person, and this is the right, this is left side, and this is the right side. Now as you all know, on the left side there is a stomach, on the left side there is a spleen. This is what? A stomach. This is a spleen, and over here this is the duodenum. This is what? Duodenum. And this is the pancreas. This is what? Pancreas. This is duodenum, this is pancreas, and on the right side this is the liver. This is what? This is liver. So this is just schematic diagram in which I am showing just orientation of the different organs to which the celiac trunk will give its branches. So here is the celiac trunk, here is the celiac trunk. So one branch will give blood to the stomach, and this is the left gastric artery, and this branch will go to the spleen, and this is a splenic artery, and this branch will go towards the liver. So this is the common hepatic artery. So on the left side there will be two branches, one is left gastric artery and a splenic artery, and on the right side, as there is a liver here, so this is the common hepatic artery for the liver. For the liver and these different organs, these different structures, duodenum and the pancreas, and also for the stomach. So this is the celiac trunk, this is the left gastric artery branch, this is the splenic artery. Splenic artery again gives four branches. One is the branches for the stomach, gastric branches, pancreatic branches, left gastroepiploic artery, and these are the, from the S, it is short gastric arteries. So these are four, GPLS. So splenic artery gives four branches, GPLS from G, gastric branches, pancreatic from P, pancreatic branches from L, left gastroepiploic, left gastroepiploic artery, and from S, these are the short arteries, short gastric arteries. Now on the right side there is a liver, so for the liver it is going common hepatic artery. Now common hepatic artery gives three branches, RPG. How many branches? Three branches, RPG. From R it is right gastric artery, from P proper hepatic artery, from G gastroduodenal artery. Now gastroduodenal artery gives branches, and its name are, one branch is the superior pancreatico-duodenal artery, and from this P it is posterior superior pancreatico-duodenal artery, and gastro-duodenal artery gives two terminal branches. Now friends, here from the S it is not superior posterior duodenal artery, it is from S it is supra duodenal artery, because superior from the terminal, because this superior pancreatico duodenal artery is the terminal branch of the gastro duodenal artery, and this superior pancreatico duodenal artery is also called as the anterior superior pancreatico duodenal artery, and from this R it is right gastro epiploic artery. Now the proper hepatic artery gives two branches, one left hepatic artery and second one is the right hepatic artery, and from the right hepatic artery there is a cystic artery branch for the gallbladder. So here you can see on the left side there is stomach, spleen, and towards the inferior side there is pancreas and the duodenum, and on the right side there is a large organ, a liver. So here this person is standing, but for our convenience we have laid down this person like this. Now as all these branches, this branch and this branch of the gastroduodenal artery are superior to the pancreas and duodenum, that is why these are all called as the superior branch. This one is the supra duodenal artery, this one is the posterior superior. Why superior? Because they are superior to the pancreas as well as duodenum, that is why they are called as the superior pancreatico duodenal artery. Why they are called as pancreas and duodenum? Because they will supply blood to the pancreas as well as duodenum, that is why they are given pancreatico duodenal. Why they are called superior, as you all know, why they are called pancreatico duodenal, and why they are called posterior, and one branch is the posterior and one branch is the anterior branch. The superior pancreatico duodenal artery is also called as the anterior superior pancreatico duodenal artery. So these both branches, anterior superior pancreatico duodenal artery as well as the posterior superior pancreatico duodenal artery, both are posterior to the duodenum, posterior to the duodenum, while the anterior branch is anterior to the pancreas, while the posterior branch from the gastroduodenal artery goes posterior to the pancreas. This is very, very important. So now here you understood very well why it is called as the posterior branch, because it is going posterior to the pancreas, and why it is called as the anterior branch, because it is going anterior to the pancreas, head of the pancreas. So head of the pancreas is supplied by these two branches, one anterior superior pancreatico duodenal artery and second one is the posterior superior pancreatico duodenal artery, while these two branches are going posterior to the duodenum. This is very, very important. So here is a very simple trick with the help of which you can easily remember all these branches. Now just write here celiac. Just write here celiac, and if I will derive the word cools from the celiac, so is there any problem in deriving cools word from the celiac, because celiac is very similar to the cools word. So you can easily remember celiac with the cools, celiac with the cools. Now from this C, as it is on right side, so this will give common hepatic artery. From this L, it is left gastric artery, as it is going on the left side for supplying blood to the stomach, and this is the splenic artery. Now from this C, just make RPG, CRPG, CRPG, and from this S, SGPLS. So these are three branches of the common hepatic artery. From this R, it is right gastric artery. From P, it is proper hepatic artery. From G, it is gastroduodenal artery. From G, it is gastric branches. From P, it is pancreatic branches. From L, left gastroepiploic artery. And from S, it is short gastric arteries. So here is our stomach. Here is our stomach. This is lesser curvature and this is greater curvature. So from the celiac trunk directly the left gastric artery is going to supply the lesser curvature. So this is what? Left gastric artery. Now from the common hepatic artery there is coming right gastric artery. So this is the right gastric artery coming for giving or blood supply to the lesser curvature, remaining part of the lesser or lower part of the lesser curvature. The upper part of the lesser curvature is supplied by the left gastric artery and lower part of the lesser curvature is supplied by the right gastric artery. Now from the splenic artery there is a short gastric branches, short gastric arteries. These short gastric arteries supply blood to the fundus part of the stomach, and this is here the left gastroepiploic artery or left gastroomental artery is also called. Left gastroepiploic artery, or you can say left gastroomental artery. So here the greater curvature is supplied by the left gastroepiploic artery, and here as you know from the gastroduodenal artery. Now here just take this word G. GSP sir. So from S it is supraduodenal artery. From P it is posterior superior pancreaticoduodenal artery. From S it is superior pancreaticoduodenal artery, and from R it is right gastroepiploic artery or right gastroomental artery. Now this right gastroepiploic or right gastroomental artery is branch of the gastroduodenal artery, is supplying blood to the remaining part of the greater curvature. So this is right gastroepiploic artery. So right gastroepiploic artery is the branch of the gastroduodenal artery. Left gastroepiploic artery and short gastric artery are the branch from the splenic artery. And this right gastric artery is the branch of the common hepatic artery, and this left gastric artery is the direct branch from the celiac trunk. So as this left gastric artery is the direct branch from the celiac trunk, that is why this left gastric artery becomes the major artery that supply blood to the stomach. So if in the MCQ it is asked that which is the main or major artery which is supplying blood to the stomach, so it is the left gastric artery. Now my dear friends, let's see once again all these branches. So this is celiac trunk just right here, Cools. So from this C it is common hepatic artery on the right side for the liver. From L it is left gastric artery. From S it is splenic artery. Common hepatic artery gives three branches. From C, just write CRPG. So these are three branches. From R, it is right gastric artery. From P, proper hepatic artery. From G, it is gastroduodenal artery. Proper hepatic artery gives two branches, right and left. From right, it is cystic artery for the gallbladder. Now gastroduodenal artery gives two normal branches. One is, just take this word, this alphabet G. So from G, it is G, sir. And who is sir? SP sir. Who is sir? SP sir. GSP sir. So from S it is supraduodenal artery. From P it is post superior pancreaticoduodenal artery. From S it is superior pancreaticoduodenal artery, that is also called as the anterior superior pancreaticoduodenal artery. From R it is right gastroepiploic artery. Then friends, we have splenic artery, and splenic artery gives four normal branches G, P, L, S, and after giving these four branches, the splenic artery goes towards the spleen to supply blood to the spleen. So these four branches are: from G it is gastric branches, from P pancreatic branches, from L left gastroepiploic artery, and from S these are the short gastric arteries. And also left gastric artery gives two branches. Some branches goes towards the esophagus to supply esophageal and forms the esophageal branches. These are the esophageal branches, and the other one are the gastric branches.